So my aim is here to give some formulas for the limiting distributions of traces of representations of the symplectic group which occur in the trace of Frobenius. First I introduce the symplectic group. We'll recall some very well-known results about equidistribution as a motivation. And then I shall speak about the distribution of the trace. And we develop the case of curves or of genus 2 and tell something about the process which is the Wiertz way. Well, first of all, the symplectic group. I recall the basics. You have the definition here of the compact symplectic group, which is a Riolli group made of complex matrices with the shape which is indicated there. And the characteristic polynomial of such a matrix has a special features, namely, this is a unitary polynomial of degree 2g. The value of 0 is 1. All the roots are on the unit circle. And the inversion is a permutation of the set of roots of chi. And the roots plus or minus 1 occur with even multiplicity. Then the map which associates the characteristic polynomial to a symplectic matrix induces an isomorphism from the set XG. XG is the set of sequence of angles between 0 and p, as indicated there. Here. And every polynomial or every conjugacy class has a representative, which is a diagonal matrix, which is drawn here. And if M is the conjugation. If the conjugation class of M is H of theta, the characteristic polynomials are the same. Okay, what about measures? And since the compact symplectic group is a compact group, so there is a R measure of total mass 1 on that group. That you can see as a probability measure. And in that way, G becomes a probability space. If this is so, the elements of G are random matrices, can be called random matrices. And if the elements of G are random matrices, a scalar random variable will be a continuous function on the on XG, the product of 0p to the power G, but symmetric, invariant by the symmetric group. And this is the same as a central continuous function on G. Now, if I take a continuous finite dimensional representation of G, then an example, an instance of such a scalar random variable is the trace of rho of H theta, or we can called Tiro is on conjugacy class. Tiro of M is the trace of rho of M, and this is a central continuous function. And for the trivial representation, the standard representation, we drop the index rho and write T of theta as a trace of H of theta, which is two times the sum of a cosinus of angles. In that way, the trace is minus A1, where A1 is the first coefficient, the second coefficient in the characteristic polynomial. And of course, all the coefficients of the characteristic polynomial are scalar random variables as well. Now we have the integration formula of Hermann Weyl, which gives the image measure of the R measure on the conjugacy classes. So the definition is that is written there, the integral over the conjugacy classes of G of scalar of a random variable is just the integral of G with respect to the R measure. And then you can pull back the measure on the conjugacy classes inherited from the R measure on the space XG, the product 0p to the power g, divided by the symmetric group, and you get a measure in that Gaussian space, which is indicated there. D mu g is absolutely continuous to the with respect to the product of the Lebesg measures, with a density delta g, which is written there. And that was a computation of Hermann Weyl. Alors, why am I interested in such integration formula and so on? This is as you know, probably because of the equidistribution of traces. But I shall briefly recall the matter for the people which were not there last week. Bon, if I have an abelian variety of dimension g of RFQ, the L polynomial of A is the characteristic polynomial of the Frobenius of A, and we perform a normalization on that polynomial by just cleaning the coefficient q to the power minus 1/2 in order to have a polynomial with roots on the unit circle. Well, in that case, the polynomial, the unitarized L polynomial, is an element of the space phi 2 g of polynomials of symplectic matrices, symmetries. And the main question is when R varies, what is the behavior of the trace of the coefficient A1, AG? At the beginning, that was Katz-Sarnak theory. In fact, before the first, there was a long trotter theory, but that was a long time ago. What do you find in the work of Katz and Sarnak? I give an example. Let me call CG of K the space of moduli of curves of genus G over K, and associate to a curve the normalized eigenvalues of the Frobenius of the Jacobian of C. According to Katz and Cernak, these vectors, when C runs over Q, and when Q runs over any prime power, are equidistributed with respect to the measure mu g. And this means precisely the equality which is written here. In the mean, for any random variable, the mean of x of theta c is equal to the Weyl integral x of theta dmu g of theta. One can substitute to the moduli space CG, the space AG of moduli of principally polarized abelian varieties of dimension G over K. I give here the reference because these results are sometimes difficult to find. And in any case, they are stated in some strange way, manner. These theorems means are stated as follows. When you take this space, the intrinsic measure is equal to the naive measure, and you have to do some work in order to understand. The Katz-Cernak theory is the first step, but it gives nevertheless some interesting result. You have the mean, first of all, you have the mean value of characteristic polynomials, which is written on the first line. And this means that in the mean, the Frobenius angles of an abelian variety are located on the vertices of polygon with 2g plus 2 vertices, excluding the point plus or minus 1. This gives you also a mean value for the number of points of an abelian variety, and a mean value for the number of points of a curve. And notice that the O is a small O. And the proof is easy. It's a consequence of Katz-Cernak by through the computation of the trace of the exterior powers of a matrix. Such a trace is equal to 1 if n is even and 0 otherwise. As a second example, I give an instance of the generalized set-rotate conjecture. Take a smooth projective curve of genus G over Q and a finite subset such that C has a good reduction if P is not in S. And I don't want to give some intricate definition, but I want to be as simple as I can. Then I say that the group, the compact symplectic group, arises as the set-rotate group of C is if the vectors of the Frobenius of the Frobenius operator of the curve are equidistant with respect to the Weyl measure. And what I mean by this equidistribution property is written here. You reduce modulo p the curve, you make the sum over all the prime numbers up to the value n. You perform the mean by dividing by the prime numbers up to n, and you take the limit. The difference between the Katz-Cernak theory and the set-rotate theory is there are lots of conjectures in set-rotate, but few proofs. And for instance, if one wants an example, we have conjectural examples where the set-rotate group is the compact symplectic group. according to Kedlayan Sutherland, this is true for a curve with odd genus, or genus equal to 2 or to 6, and with no complex no multiplication at all, no non-trivial endomorphisms of the Jacobian. The difference between the two is horizontal versus vertical equidistribution. For the Katz-Sarnak theory, you make the vertical sum. This gives you a measure, and then you compute horizontally the limit of this measure of mass one. This is the measure, for instance, corresponding to the value q. And Sato Tet is horizontal distribution because you consider only one curve. Bon, I want to give some precisions on the distribution of a random variable. If I have a random variable on the conjugacy class of on the space of a continuous function on xg, the zero means that it is in a symmetric function. The image is a compact interval. And the distribution of x is just the measure, which is the image of the veil measure mu g by x. So the definition of the image measure is written here. For any continuous function on the image of x, phi x d mu of x is equal to phi of x of theta d mu g of theta on the space of conjugacy class, or the space 0 to pi to the power g divided by the symmetric function, by the symmetric group. And then, when you have this, you know exactly the probability that a variable is less than x. This is just the integral. So we can apply this to the trace function. The regular trace function, and the image is minus 2g to g. And you apply this, the distribution of t is exactly the measure which, when you calculate this integral for any function in the image, you get d mu t. And my aim is to compute d mu t. Bon, in order to compute mu t, first, the repartition function of t is ft of x is the probabilities for which the random variable t is less than x. So this is just the integral for the trace inferior to x. And by Fubini theorem, you can decompose this integral by integrating from minus infinity to x the ds on the integral on a level hypersurface t of theta equal s with suitable measure on that hypersurface. Roughly speaking, the exterior product of d alpha and ds is equal to d mu g. So the distribution of mu of t, the distribution mu t of t, can be written as ft of x dx. That is, it is absolutely continuous with respect to the Lebesgue measure, and with the density which is given by this integral over an hypersurface. And this this is you can bon. these computations are, you can't find them in the book of Serre on nx of p. Well, the characteristic function of t is a Fourier transform of mu t of x. I just wrote the definition of the Fourier transform. This, the definition lift back to an integral over the power 0p to the power g. And I see that here the quotient by the symmetric group is missing. And what is interesting is by Fourier inversion, you get the density as the inverse Fourier transform of the characteristic function. So now, what I want to do is to express the characteristic function on the density of the distribution of the trace with what's called the Higer transcendental functions of Batman or special functions. Alors, I shall be concerned with USP4, which corresponds to curves of genus 2. Here is the density of the veil measure on USP4, and the veil measure on USP4 is written here. And about the characteristic function of the distribution of the trace, when g is equal to 2, then the trace is 2 times the sum of the 2 cosine of the characteristic polynomial. And the characteristic function has an explicit formula, which is here. And this integral can be calculated, and you obtain that result. The characteristic function of t is the sum of three product of Bessel functions. G1 and G2 are the classical Bessel functions. So the distribution mu t is defined by the sequence of its moments. The moment of a distribution of a measure is the integral against x to the power n of the measure. Here we can write the moments as the power of the traces, and the moments here can be calculated by a Taylor series, because the sum of it's a general fact that the characteristic function is given by the coefficient of the Taylor series of the characteristic functions are the moments in that case. But in terms of hypergeometric series, the sum of these three Bessel functions reduces to only one hypergeometric series, which is 1F2, 3 half, 3, 4, minus 4 t square, with the series which is written there. And the comparison of these two series expansion gives you immediately the moments, which are written there. And the formula appears in Kedlayer and Sutherland, and also in a note in the Sloan catalog attributed to Mihailov, and this is also this is in the Book of Serre. But now that I know the characteristic function by a Fourier inversion, I can come back to the density. And for this, I need the Legendre function. What I need is the associated Legendre function of the first kind, associated because there is a parameter A, and when A is equal to zero, this is just the Laplace integral. This is a classical special function. And with this, I can give a first expression of the density. The density can be expressed by the Legendre function P2 1/2 of x squared plus 16 over 4x with correcting coefficient, which is here. So this is the formula for the density of the trace on SP4. The maximum is when x is equal to zero, and the value is 64 over 15 p squared. And when x goes to four, the density goes to zero, and as she goes to zero very quickly, as epsilon 4 over 64 pi. So we get this picture. If we draw the function, the corresponding Legendre function, we obtain this picture. And this picture is appears in the paper of Kedlai and Sutherland. And one sees that this is a standard normal variable. In French, une variable aléatoire centrée réduite, because the mean is equal to zero and the standard deviation is equal to one. Okay, and we can give a second expression for the density with the help of a major G function. Well, so roughly speaking, major G functions are inverse Mellin transforms of quotient and product of gamma functions, like that. Here you have product of gamma function in the numerator, in the denominator, and you perform the inverse Mellin transform of this on a Mellin bounds contour, like as indicated here. In fact, this is an artist view because the contour must the form of the contour depends on the positions of AK and BK. But in some simple case, this can be this contour is sufficient. But the major G functions is a class of functions which is interesting because it is closed by lots of operations like multiplication, convolution, and so on. And the second expression for the density of the trace is that the density is equal to 6 over pi to g of x squared over 16 for the major G function, which is written on the right. on the G of Z is just the inverse Mellin transform of gamma S, gamma S plus 1, gamma S plus 5 half, and gamma S four plus 7 half. There is also a third expression of FT. And because in their recent paper, Fitte, Kedlaya, and so on, and Sutherland, and so on, say that the density of the trace can be expressed as elliptic integrals, but they don't write down precisely the formula, and the formula is here. This is the sum of the two elliptic integrals of Legendre with polynomial coefficients in front of them. And okay, so we have the density of the trace, and the repartition function is obtained by taking the primitive. Then the primitive can be defined as a major G function, which is written there. And this, since we know the major, since we know the repartition function, we can draw it with the help of a computer, and we obtain this picture. Okay, now I switch to another approach of computations, which is Vieth's way, which is from a project of David Coel, because program can be confusing. This is not a software, but an ID from a project of David Coel. Bon, I make a preliminary change of variables from by taking an algebraic form of Weyl's integration formula. Then on the left, you have the usual Weyl integral, and by the change of variables, t is equal to 2 cosinus theta, and the same from 1 to g. Then you can write the Weyl integration formula as an integral over the product of g samples of the interval minus 2, 2 with this density, which is in fact algebraic and no longer analytic. So the Vieth map, is just the map associating the basic symmetric functions to a sequence of numbers. So if I have a polynomial f with roots t1, tg, the elementary symmetric functions of t1, tg are S1 of t, Sg of t. And you get in that way a map, a polynomial map from Cg to Cg. And I won't use this map for performing a change of variables. And for this, I need to know what is exactly the image of the e to the power g. Because here, we are integrating over eg. So we need to know the image. And if we know that, at that time, the change of variable will give you the algebraic Weyl integral here with the algebraic density here as the integral over the image with another density, a suitable density nu g. And for the image of the real space RG by the Viet the Viet map, if you want to compute it, we first define the sums, the Newton sums, I think, of the powers of the value T1, Tg, and define the matrix which is written there. And there is a result by Hermit that T1, Tg are real and distant if and only if the matrix R is a positive, positive definite matrix. Now there is a formula by Albert Girard of 116 and 29, which allows you to recover the product from the symmetric functions. And this is a combinatorial formula. I don't spell it here. But if you know the symmetric, the basic symmetric function S1, Sg, then you know the sum of powers, P1, Pg. Now, Pg, so we have a formula for Pg, and Pg appears here. So I substitute in the matrix R, I substitute to P1, Pg, the value which is here. I get a polynomial matrix depending on S1, Sg, and expressing that it must be positive definite give me a condition for the T to be real. And this provides G polynomials, and one of them is the discriminant of F. F is that one. And I call the discriminant F, I call it D of S1, S1, Sg. Alors now we can give some equations for the integration domain epsilon G. And recall that epsilon G is the image of Eg by S, e to the power G by S. Bon, firstly, as I said, the Viet domain of the real numbers is given by polynomials, M1, Mg. And then, if I want to restrict to the intervals minus 2 plus 2, this reduces to two G linear condition. This condition define a polyhedron with 2G linear form, L plus 1, L plus G, L minus 1, L minus G, and so on. And these are the equations, and there are algorithms for computation of all these equations, the M1, Mg, and the L1, Lg. For instance, in the case where g equals 2, the integration domain is like that. And we can use that integration domain just in order to calculate the distribution of the second trace. I consider the representation the exterior product of the standard representation. I call V6 the standard the representation of the symplectic the compact symplectic group on the exterior power, the second exterior power of V4. Then, by construction, the trace of V6 is equal to A2, A2 being the second coefficient appearing in the third term here. And if you apply the Viète construction, you find readily that the density of S is given by an integral over one an integral of one variable, dz. And you integrate this function in the two integral in the alors if and these are not the same in the if x is negative or if x is positive. If x is between minus 4 and 0, you take for e that interval. And between 0 and 4, you take the union of two intervals which are symmetric. And this comes because here you take slices. You take horizontal slices of that domain. Here, there is only one interval, but here you have two. And such an integral can be calculated. Then the distribution has a density, and the density is written here. And there are two different formulas according to the sign of x. And these are, as for the usual trace, the sum of two elliptic, Legendre elliptic function, A and K, E and K, E of Z and K of Z, and Z is this rational fraction. So with this computation, we can we can draw the density of the distribution of S. The maximum is on the left of the graph. The maximum is here. At minus 0.6 and so on, and is equal to 0.4 and so on. And this, the value here is 8 over 3 pi squared. And there is a discontinuity because the derivative of the graph is logarithmic at zero. Alors, this is not a standard normal variable because the mean is equal to minus one and the standard deviation is equal to two. But if we perform a shift of one, if we put g of x is equal to f minus x minus one, we get a standard normal variable. And maybe the reason is that the second representation here of G on the exterior power of V4 is not irreducible, but is a sum of the representation of USP4 on SO5 and trivial representation. And maybe this is responsible for that deviation. Okay, we can have give another look to the density of the. I come back to the density of the trace. This one is quickly obtained by integration of the density of veil on a fiber. And in such a way, in this way, you have a formula which gives you the density, Ft, t is missing here, as the integral on the integration domain epsilon g cut by the hyperplane where S1 equals x of that measure, which is the nu of s ds divided by ds1. You can do this for g equal 2, and if g equal 2, you get the result we have already obtained. And this is a particular case of a construction which is in the book of Serre. Now for g equals 3, you get another integration domain, which is drawn here. You have three, it's defined by, at first, three polynomials on six linear forms, but it is easy to see that you can reduce this to one polynomial on three linear forms. And I apply the Viet approach for g equals 3. The discriminant of f is written here. And the density of the distribution, the veil density for the algebraic formula is here. And the domain of integration is just written here. So I just plug in these results on the general formula obtain a two-dimensional variable integral. I have not been able to compute it explicitly in terms of special functions, but in any case, that's sufficient for computing the density numerically by computer. So in the case where g equals 3, this is the graph of the density of the distribution of the trace. You can calculate the moments, and you see that this is as well also a standard normal variable. Okay, thank you.